And I declare the motion passed.
Fifth member's motion. Motion under the Legislative Council Powers and Privileges Ordinance. Members who wish to speak on this motion will please press the Request to Speak button. I now call upon Ms. Cyd HO to speak and move the motion. Ms. Cyd HO. President, I move that a motion, as printed on the agenda, be passed. This motion is to invoke Legal Powers and Privileges Ordinance to set up a select committee to inquire into whether the Chief Executive of the Hong Kong SAR, Mr. Leung Chun-ying's claim that three professionals have provided advice on the unauthorized building works in his house numbers 4 and 5 at number 4 Pew Rise on the Peak involved false statement or misrepresentation, and whether Mr. Leung had given any improper undertaking in exchange for the support of members of the election committee when he stood for the 2012 Chief Executive election. President, today, is the in a short span of 1 year, the fourth time that this council has to consider motions to inquire into his misconduct. And this is the second time we want to invoke the Legal Powers and Privileges Ordinance. That would include the 10th of December with the CE's question time. Mr. Wu Chi-wai raised a motion of no confidence in December. And on the 19th of December, Mr. Lee Cheuk-yan proposed the setting up a select committee to inquire into the case. And Mr. Leung got home on the 9th of January, moved a motion to impeach the CE. Although this case of UBWs and the misconduct on the part of the CE to cover up the incident and also the not-so-truthful statement that he made. He said, I didn't say that I had no UBWs. These are not truthful statements. However, in this council, which is not democratically constituted, none of the motions to impeach him or to set up a select committee was passed. This is the fourth time that I have to raise this. I feel sorry about this, President. Hong Kong deserves to have a CE with integrity. We should have a CE who honors morals and who knows when to step down. We shouldn't have this UBW incident and then a series of misstatement or cover-ups warranting motions like this to ask for an investigation to be carried out. We shouldn't have a CE which have attracted so much doubts and lack of trust. I have to raise this because there is new information. And that is the CE's attitude is a very blurred and uncertain concerning whether there were three professionals who inspected his houses. And then there's a new development. Mr. Liu Mong Hong was interviewed by the iSun Affairs, in which, in that interview, Mr. Liu made very specific accusations which are alarming. I just want to raise 2 points covered by that report, because they were the allegations about criminality or offenses. According to Mr. Liu, there were no three professionals as referred to by Mr. Leung Chun-ying. It's all made up. And also Mr. Zhang Zhanyu, Mr. Barry Zheng was also involved. So if it's a makeup story that there were three professionals, it shows that over the recent period of time, and when it comes to the allegation or the statement of Mr. Leung Chun-ying that the house was inspected by professionals, well, it's a big lie. Mr. Liu also said, on the 15th of December, or the 16th of December 2011, he couldn't remember clearly. And that is in Mr. Leung's office on the 16th floor of Jardine's house. And I quote from this report, "Mong Hong, you are now working so hard to support me. If I win, what do you want? What kind of office would you like? What kind of role would you like to play in the new government?" Obviously, he's trying to exchange support with public office. And then Mr. Liu gave more details. There was a promise by Mr. Siwa Leung that Mr. Liu Mohong would be made an executive counselor. But this is a very serious and specific accusation. Because if you try to exchange support or gain support by offering a public office, it can be an offense under the ECICO. Concerning election corrupt conduct. There's a 200 square feet underground space, which is an UBW. Last time when we discussed the proposed impeachment, Mr. Dennis Kwok gave us a careful analysis. That is, in November 2011, without any approval from the buildings department, Mr. CY Leung erected a brick wall to cover the to seal up the entrance to the UBW. So the attitude is very clear by his own act. And in May 2011, Mr. CY Leung invited people from media organizations to have lunch with him. And he told those media people that when he moved into the house, he invited three professionals, including two lawyers and one architect, to inspect the house on his behalf to try to see if there's any problem. That's crucial. If the professionals told him that there was no problem, then notwithstanding the underground space being a UBW, there would be a defense available. But if there was no such professional advice rendered, and as Mr. Liu Menghong has alleged, it's a make-up story, then it's a very serious case. In this CE's question time, or in our discussion of the motions on this subject, the Pan Democrats have been asking the CE to tell us who these three professionals were. And we haven't got anything, not even the architect. It has been said that the architect has passed away, so there's no one to bear witness. We don't even have the name of the architect. Mr. CY Leung has been saying that this is a matter of privacy and that he doesn't want to hurt the architect's family. So all along, there's been no disclosure on the identity of this professional. The public are not assured. Is this really true, or is it just a story? And all these have to do with the CE's integrity. And that's why we wanted to have an investigation carried out by the Chief Justice, but that was not passed. And now we have new information pointing to very serious criminal offenses. We cannot sit by and do nothing. So notwithstanding, this is the fourth time, we have to move a motion here that in the light of the new information, I hope council members and parties represented here will not try to cover up and protect this lying CE. Please, in the light of the new information, agree to the setting up of a select committee to inquire into the very specific allegations made by Mr. Liu Menghong and the misrepresentations and false statements which have been made on a continuous basis. There should be an independent and fair competition. We have been following up this issue of three professionals for some time, so I don't need to repeat the points which have been made. Mr. Liu Menghong claims that a public office was offered to reward support for the CE. Although it was 8 weeks before the election day, that is 8 weeks before the 23rd of March 2012, but the electioneering started very early. He resigned as an executive member on the 3rd of October 2011, preparing to get ahead with his election campaign. And he told the media that he was determined to go ahead and run for the office. And on the 27th of November 2011, well, there was a forum organized for his supporters. And some of our colleagues were there. So this is the dialogue between Mr. Liu and the CE and the Mr. Leung, and that is what kind of role would you like to have in the new government? It was made in mid-December 2011, and that is to say, that was after Mr. Leung announced his intention to run for the office of CE. So he was in the process of organizing his campaign. If he did make this pledge, he would have committed an offense under the ECICO. We would have thought that trying to sell public offices was something that we would see in ancient China. And now we are in the third millennium, 2013. We were under the rule of a Western democracy for 150 years, and we have a long and cherished tradition of the rule of law. Still, there we are now witnessing such a case of trying to provide a public office as a reward. That's not something we can accept here in Hong Kong. And Mr. C.Y. Leung has not properly responded to the allegations made by Mr. Liu Menghong. In an activity where the CE was on board a plane with some local people, the media asked him to respond to Mr. Liu's allegations for a long 3-minute period and got no response. And for Mr. Lin Yiu-chung, who'd published a commentary, and then in the headline, the reference is made to the giving an account in a specified place at a specified time, and also talking about the CE's background with someone from the background of red and from the background of black giving support. Mr. C.Y. Leung responded by issuing Mr. Lian with a solicitor's letter. The letter has not been published, but it said that he took a serious view about the requirement to give an account at a specified place at a specified time, because that was the disciplinary procedure applied to the Communist Party members. So maybe that's why he minded so much about this reference. To avoid problems with his UPWs, Mr. C.Y. Leung has made false statements in this council, and has also blatantly trying to suppress press freedom. Such conduct affects our core values and good governance in Hong Kong. That's why I want to move this motion. And I hope members of this council will no longer try to sue this CE.
I now propose the question to you, and that is that the motion moved by Ms. Cyd HO be passed. Secretary for Constitutional and Mainland Affairs. Mr. Deputy, Ms. Cyd HO is moving a motion under the Electrical Powers and Privileges Ordinance to set up a select committee to inquire into whether the CE's claim amounted to false statement or misrepresentation, or whether there was any improper undertaking given in exchange for the support in an election. I want to say that concerning the building works, Mr. Cy Wai-lun has given a very clear account on many occasions. And concerning the CE election in 2012, the administration has emphasized time and again that the election was carried out in accordance with the basic law and the relevant legislation. And if there are allegations, there are established procedures to deal with them. And law enforcement agencies, of course, deal with such allegations and complaints very seriously. And so there is no need for the LegCo to set up a select committee to carry out any investigation. The administration opposes the motion, and I will respond after I have listened to members' views.
Does any member wish to speak? A point of order, please. No? The clerk, please.
現在有足夠的法定人數，郭家麒議員。
We now have a quorum. Dr. Kwakaki, Mr. Deputy, I speak in support of Ms. Cyd Ho's motion to request this council to appoint a select committee to inquire into a whole series of incidents resulting from Mr. C.Y. Leung's UBWs on the peak. We're actually overtaken by events. Just ask anybody outside, ask whether they believe in C.Y. Leung. I don't think there are that many people who still trust in C.Y. Leung. I think the public has already formed their views. There's no way for us to trust him anymore. But what's lacking is accountability. Last week, the Buildings Department, before the statutory deadline, took out a prosecution in relation to the residents of the former CS for administration, Mr. Henry Tang, and related persons, the agent, the authorized persons, the contractor, and the architect were prosecuted. However, it's difficult for us to accept that from last year to this year, after a year, C.Y. Leung's residence on the peak is still not explained by any person, any stakeholder, including C.Y. Leung himself in this council. They did not tell us honestly what happened. In ISUN Weekly, Mr. Lu Mon Hon said that C.Y. Leung said in May 2011 that three professionals provided advice on the peak residence of C.Y. Leung. And Mr. Lu Mon Hong said that those three professionals did not exist. Former CPU consultant, Dr. Joseph Lien, wrote an article in Hong Kong Economic Journal. He only cited Mr. Lu Mon Hong. He pointed out that the election of C.Y. Leung as the chief executive might involve tried and non-tried people, and he should be placed under due discipline. But then C.Y. Leung issued a lawyer's letter to the Hong Kong Economic Journal and Joseph Lien, forcing Economic Journal to back down. Well, Economic Journal backed half down by publishing a statement. If Lu Mon Hong told lies, I believe C.Y. Leung would have sued him very fiercely, but he did not do so. On the street, I asked people, C.Y. Leung and Lu Mon Hong, whom do you believe? They told me they would not trust C.Y. Leung. They'd rather believe Lu Mon Hong. Our chief executive is not even as good as Lu Mon Hong. Well, Lu Mon Hong was kicked off the list of CPPCC. It's not necessary for him to fabricate information. If C.Y. Leung told the truth, he should not be afraid of coming here. Our select committees are not monsters eating people. We just want him to stand here to tell us the truth. Why should he evade our request so many times? Why should he have all the pro-government camp members here supporting him? Well, he should stand here. He bowed, and then we should applaud with a trustworthy CE. How come Lu Mon Hong said all these about C.Y. Leung. We gave him chance after chance, such that he can stand in front of the public and explain himself. But he never accepted our invitation. In fact, we do not need the pro-government members to defend him. If he dares enough, he should come here and explain himself. This is not the Middle Ages. We won't use torture to pressurize him into saying something. Lu Monhong said that he had fetched C.Y. Leung, and then what if Democrats chased after him? He telephoned again, and then Chang Chuan-yun, the former CEO office director, said that all the three professionals did not exist. How come? He is our CE, but time and again, he told lies. It doesn't matter he tells lies, but when he tells lies, he's actually sacrificing the credibility of the whole SARG and that of the 160,000 civil servants. We must not tolerate this. 10 years ago, when he took over the residence, he said that he had obtained advice from three professionals, and he said that one of them had passed away. It's really teasable. Be it a professional lawyer or a deceased surveyor, he should take this opportunity to explain clearly to the public. In December last year, C.Y. Leung published a statement which says that apart from the solicitor's firm for preparation of the deed, he had obtained verbal advice from a surveyor. Well, he's really very clever and smart. He said that he had obtained verbal advice from a certain professional, but that professional had already passed away. So what can we do? Verbal. And now the person does not exist anymore. Under such circumstances, if we still let him off the hook, it's our shame. If legislative members do not fulfill its responsibility, role and function by resorting to the Electoral Powers and Privileges Ordinance to find out the truth, then we're being irresponsible and we're insulting all those voters who voted for us. Our request is not complicated at all. Perhaps we only need one simple procedure, and then the whole incident will finish. We only need, perhaps, the name of that professional. When did he offer his advice? Well, only one out of the three had passed away. That's what we heard. Are we going to wait till all the three of them had passed away before we pursue the incident? We still have two live witnesses. Should we not invite these two live witnesses to come and testify whether or not they have advised that there are no UBWs in this residence? And after that, Mr. Chang Chuan-yun said that the solicitor's firm has been disclosed, but then the professional has passed away. The name was not disclosed with the explanation that they do not want to affect the family members of that professional. Well, perhaps we should go through the list of deceased professionals to find out who that person was. Legislative members should not try to defend the CE in this scandal. As Joseph Land said in his article, if this incident involves triads or triad-related issues, how can we trust the CE anymore? How can we trust the government anymore? Because the government has not rectified this very big mistake of the mistakes of C.Y. Leung. And in paragraph 46 of C.Y. Leung's statement last November, he said that he discovered out of his initiative that a basement had been expanded. And then in November 2011, he dismantled the UBW, as he said. He had already handled the UBW. And there's no evidence and no witness. Did that really happen? What did he do in November 2011? Is it that the UBW no longer existed? He had already handled it? The LegCo has exhausted all means to give him opportunities. His assistant, his secretary for development were given chances. On the 12th of December last year, in an oral reply, I asked, under Section 14, under what circumstances, without the prior consent of the BA, a landowner could seal off a UBW by a brick wall? And then, what about the non-existence of the UBW? Could that be put up as an explanation or defense? And Mr. Paul Chan did not really say anything. For over 20 minutes, so many members were queuing up for supplementary questions. We asked questions very fairly, and we now want a select committee to ask fair questions such that the parties concerned can answer our questions in a fair manner. But then the pro-establishment members again and again defended the CE. We must have the least core credibility, which had once been the pride of our civil servants. The civil service spirit is to follow the rules and regulations, and now all these are damaged and destroyed. Recently, I read articles which say that many civil servants are not convinced. For so many years, they've been following a good system, and now all these are no longer needed. They only need to go astray, and sometimes they're even encouraged to go astray. Well, by hook or by crook, so long as I get what I want, it would be all right. So how can Hong Kong still be Asia's world city? For our motherland, well, former ICAC commissioner, former commissioner of police, when they're appointed CPPCC members, they said proudly that they would like to know how they could assist our motherland. For example, in terms of corruption, corruption is everywhere on the mainland. All right, with two former law enforcement officers, we'll wait and see how they can assist. But if even the CE can fabricate stories, of course it's fabrication. He's fabricating a person. He's been fabricating stories. So we're not qualified to go to the mainland and tell people how to combat corruption, blah, blah, blah. So we're the same as other cities on the mainland. We no longer need the Constitutional and Mainland Affairs Bureau. We should have a uniform system. Let's all join in corruption. Let's all get involved in the triads. For this UBW incident, time and again, we're unable to manifest justice. I believe this time the CITO's request cannot escape its destiny. Under the protection of the pro-establishment members and the functional constituencies, I believe this select committee will not come forth. But I believe the eyes of the public are clear. They see that Hong Kong is in a bottomless pit. they see that the credibility of the SARG is no longer there. And the culprit is the government and the governing officials. Thank you.
Ms. Claudia Mo. Thank you, Mr. Deputy. Ms. Cid Ho's motion mentioned that during the election period, did the CE give any improper undertaking in exchange for the support to his campaign? Well, such accusations were published in an interview by iSun Affairs of Mr. Lu Mon Hung. And who do you trust is your own choice. Mr. Lu accused the CE of making this and that undertakings during the election period, and that he has turned his back on him. Now, it is not against the law for you to go back on your promise. And of course, it's wrong to say that you pull away your plank after using it to cross the bridge. No, this is wrong. Well, it is just a selfish act. It's okay for you not to be considerate of others, but in fact is forgiving or forgetting a favor someone has done to you. Again, it is not a crime. Mr. Leung is accused of having links with the triads. Now, the CE, in his personal capacity, issued a letter to the Hong Kong Economic Journals to Mr. Joseph Lien. Well, the lawyers would like to say that everyone is equal in front of the law. No, in front of the law, even in front of the media, not everyone enjoys absolute equality. Well, for your neighbor, Mr. Chen, to have a concubine, it's okay. He will not be prosecuted, but if the CE keeps a concubine, a mistress, then it is a big thing. Now, assuming that A and B are both involved in a sex scandal, now if Mr. A is a pastor or a priest, then his sin is a double, because he has abused his position, and also he has betrayed the trust of the victim to him. But in his pastoral capacity, Mr. Siwai Leung claims that he sent a letter, a lawyer's letter, to Hong Kong Economic Journals in his personal capacity. It's not easy for media. Organization to be intimidated, but then he is using his influence to intimidate a commentator, just a scholar. And I think he is infringing on the freedom of expression, freedom of the press. And then on another occasion, the Hong Kong Journalist Association had a charter in very enlarged print, and candidates, including Siwai Leung, were asked to sign to that charter to a pledge their support for freedom of the press. Now, Siwai Leung claimed that the lawyer's letter was sent in his personal capacity. Well, this fact has been known to everyone, while the content is still kept confidential, because he used his own personal capacity to do it, and that he claims protection under personal privacy. However, a press release by the government said that the CE is accused of having links with the triads by an article by Mr. Joseph Lien, and then it is a very serious matter, and therefore he has to deal with it very seriously. Well, this is really white terror. It is a brutal blow on freedom of expression and freedom of the press. Now, if allegations that he has links with triads has to be taken seriously, what about my accusation that he is introducing white terror? Will I receive a letter from his lawyer as well in front of law? Am I equal with Mr. Joseph Lien back then? Mr. James Tan of the Liberal Party said that the business sector was not against Cheuk-yan Leung's policies, but against this person, Cheuk-yan Leung, and that he is incompetent. All right, personally, what has he done before and after his election? What's wrong? What is his association with triads and other elements? I think we should ask him to come clean so that Hong Kong can restore stability. Mr. Robert Jung, responsible for Hong Kong Youth Poll, which is most credible according to my opinion, the confidence rate, or rather, many indices on to reflect freedoms in Hong Kong has dropped. The poll was done in between the 4th and the 14th of February, just during the Lunar New Year vacation. And during that period, the most controversial piece of news against Cheuk-yan Leung is that he, in his personal capacity, sent a lawyer's letter to Hong Kong EJ and Mr. Joseph Lin. If Cheuk-yan Leung indeed during his election promised certain favors to somebody in return for his support in the C election, well, there is the suspicion of corruption in the election. We must pursue this. Well, I think that his legal structures is still a problem, but I will set this aside and I talk about whether he has made any inappropriate, improper undertaking during the election period. I think only this alone would warrant us to invoke the Electoral Powers and Privileges Ordinance to pursue the matter. Now, he is suspected to have links with triads and is expected to impose white terror. In fact, we've seen signs of white terror in Hong Kong. I dare not say for sure the pan-democrats would certainly give unqualified support to LSD because he is a member of the pan-democratic camp. I think LSD faces very strong political pressure. Obviously, the police have selectively chosen to prosecute members of LSD. Examples are abundant. In terms of arrests, well, it's just illegal assembly. Should the persons involved be arrested in the early hours of the morning by CIDs from his own place? And I think Cheuk-yan Leung would like to follow the ideology of the Chinese Communist Party. He would like to have a firm grip over Hong Kong, and I think he is very blatant in suppressing the opposition. Well, if you swear or use foul language and lecho, you don't have to face any consequence. You call this an august legislature, but somebody has used a swear word beginning with F to insult the Chinese nation. How come he doesn't have to face any consequence? But for an ordinary member of the public, I just organize a legal or peaceful assembly, a rally, and then he is charged with 3 counts of creating public disorder in one day. Well, you may say that it has nothing to do with Cheuk-yan Leung. In fact, his status, his position can be compared with no one in Hong Kong, Mr. Deputy. Even you are not equal to Cheuk-yan Leung in terms of his status and capacity. Well, Cheuk-yan Leung says that accusations that he have links with tribes should be taken seriously. I think the suspicion that he has imposed white terror in Hong Kong should also be taken seriously. I support Ms. Sid Ho's motion. We have to take it very serious as to what Cheuk-yan Leung has given, what undertaking he has given during the election. And we're asking to use the PNP ordinance. It's just a very simple procedure. Thank you.
Mr. Albert Ho, Mr. Deputy, some colleagues may say, well, you're a bit long-winded. There has been similar requests in the past, including investigation using the PNP ordinance. Why do you come back one more time? Well, it's simple, because there is fresh evidence, important evidence, evidence coming from a Leung supporter. He is the pioneer of the Leung supporter, Leung supporters. This Mr. Liu, he is the number one fan. He took the lead to hand out leaflets, advertise, publicize, and he spoke things that other Leung supporters didn't dare to speak. And he spoke those eloquent words to attack his opponents. And what he has reviewed are quite shocking. First, he specifically said that there are three professionals who have inspected the Peak's home of CY Leung and said to CY Leung that there was no problem, there was no illegal structures. He said the whole thing was a fabrication. Number two, there was a political transaction, a political dealing. CY Leung promised that he would become an executive counselor, or he would make a recommendation for him to become a member of the CPPCC. There may be many dealings, but what is involved here? What is the offer? It's not just for him to fight the war for him. There may be dealings with the triad. Say, for example, what happened in that dinner? Well, apart from taking CY Leung to meet up with a media tycoon at the airport, what else is there? What more? What can't be said that is done under the table? Lu Menghong gave an explosive interview. What shocked us was not just the fact that CY Leung, our chief executive, is the person involved in this interview. What's more is that CY Leung did not give a rebuttal point by point. This is unimaginable. Well, I'm not asking him to prove him wrong, but at least you should come out to say, to clarify. And still, today, to this day, the material person's identity is still concealed. Well, we know that there are two lawyers involved, but they don't know how to tell whether something is an illegal structure. But there is an authorized person, a material person who can tell whether there is a legal structure, but his or her identity is still not disclosed. Is this the reason why he cannot come out to clarify? What's more, the dealings, there was no denial. Have you made any promises whatsoever? But people may think if there were no promises in the first place, then how come that you would append your signature on the letter produced by Lu when you have already recommended someone else? You said that you were reluctant. So has this happened at all? There was no rebuttal, no denial. Well, I don't know if the secretary has the authorization to rebut these points one by one. Well, otherwise, I don't know why he's here. At least we need to see that there is a stance. So what kind of person is CY Leung? This is a full display of what kind of person he is. There is not a word of truth coming from his mouth. He will say whatever it takes to achieve his means, his end. And it gives the impression that he will resort to whatever means he can think of. To achieve the end, regardless of whether this is a just or legal means. And I do think that Lu Menghong has become a mirror that has shown the true face of CY Leung. I can tell you that if today this motion is passed, of course, I know that is wishful thinking, but if it is passed, this inquiry will be most interesting, that will attract most eyeballs. And I do think that even if it is broadcast by ATV, the viewing rates will hit through the roof, because everyone is interested to hear what Lu Menghong has to say. What more will he review? What more that is hidden from our eyes will be reviewed? I believe that what he has said is just the tip of the iceberg. So you can imagine the amount that is underneath with the enthusiastic questions asked by my fellow members. I do think that he will enthusiastically answer them all. Members of the public will benefit because they will know more about the truth. But of course, it's one's word against that of the others. Well, will we consider introducing the use of technology, say, like a polygraph? Well, I think itself is a good thing. So CY Leung can do a one-off against Lu Menghong. And Lu Menghong said that not only will he go through the lie detector test afterwards in order to show that he is true, in order to show that what he said is true, he would jump off from IFC too. I do think a confrontation is necessary because you will find out whose word is true, and perhaps we should use a lie detector as well. I do think it will be a great show when he finally comes. And if CY Leung is honest, of course it's a big if, a lot of people will not agree that this if will come true. If he makes a clean breast of the whole matter, I do think that we will find the answer to a lot of puzzles we have in our minds. I do think that the popularity of CY Leung is beyond resuscitation. If this is to continue, I think no one will be able to save him. Ms. Cyd HO has a very important task today. But now we have new evidence, we have fresh evidence, and a very willing witness, someone who knows the ins and outs of the matter, someone who was an insider, someone who is a supporter in the Leung supporters camp, someone who enjoyed a special status. There is no reason why we would not give him our full attention, to give him a protected environment so that he can say his piece. But CY Leung dodges the issue. It's not just that he lacks courage, because he's afraid that the truth will review him as a dishonest person. I believe that the Democratic Party and Pan Democrats will fully support Ms. Ho's motion.
其他同事想發言?
Does any member wish to speak? Mr. Leung Yiu-chung. President, Ms. Ho's motion today is about whether Mr. C.Y. Leung was involved in unlawful false statement of representation, whether there was any improper undertaking in exchange for the support of members of the election committee. Now, Mr. Tan, please stay, because I'm really talking about you. You gave a very succinct reply, and you said that the chief executive has already made the clarification, and also the SAR government will be acting in accordance with the basic law and deal with the matter in a fair and honest manner, and there is no need for a select committee to be formed at the council. If I may put this to the secretary, now, on the question of unauthorized building works, you said the chief executive had already made the clarification, and there was no need to say anything further. Do you think that you have really been true to your conscience? Do you think that you are conspiring with the wicked, or do you think you are being party to this problem? Let's say there is a policeman and he's arrested a thief. Now, the thief normally would say that he hasn't done anything wrong. Now, does it mean that the police would set him free? This is precisely the case now, assuming that the chief executive has already made the clarifications. Does it mean that we can leave it aside? Many members of the public and also the media are aware that there was lie after lie in his clarifications. I hope the secretary would pay attention to that. The director of buildings and the buildings department are perceived to be suffering from credibility problem. On this particular saga, they are perceived to be unable to deal with the matter fairly. There is a favoritism involved. And you said that clarifications have been made, there is no need to pursue the matter any further. Do you think it is fair to the buildings department? Don't you think that the whole government is dragged into it, and it would be very difficult for the administration to implement future policies? Don't you see any problems with that? On the question of election, you said that you will deal with this matter seriously in accordance with the law. Now, Ms. Cyd HO made the point that she was concerned about improper undertaking. She didn't use the word illegal. Now, we don't have any concrete evidence to show any illegality. We merely are talking about improper undertaking. Like, with this in mind, why is it wrong for us to pursue the matter? It is not illegal, yet if it is illegal, then you would not allow anyone not to enforce the law. So why do you raise objection? I think Why do you say that we should not pursue the matter given the improper undertaking? Mr. Deputy, there is another issue here. Well, there is a saying in Chinese that true gold fears no fire. Why are you shielding the chief executive from an investigation if he hasn't committed any wrongdoing? Why fear any investigation? Why do you have to be so evasive and try to duck from the issue? Many fellow members made the point a moment ago that Mr. Joseph Lin referred to involvement with Trial Society, and C.Y. Leung chose to issue a lawyer's letter. And he has a credibility problem. Why does he not take the matter seriously? To take the matter seriously, he should stand up and be investigated in order to clear his name. Isn't it right, Mr. Secretary? Why didn't you encourage him to do so? Why do you conspire with him and urge fellow members not to support a Cyd HO's motion? I think this is a matter of serious gravity. The chief executive suffering from credibility problem, and you're still leaping to his defense. And don't you think that it would be very difficult for the administration to implement the policies? I'm not sure whether you've been involved in any hearings that we held. Many attendees said that the chief executive is a liar, and they cast doubt on the credibility of the top secretaries. How do you think that the government can function? How can you believe Director of Hong Kong, the liaison office, Mr. Zhang Xiaoming, in saying that the chief executive enjoyed credibility which is better than what is depicted in the media? Now, the chief executive and the government as a whole enjoy very low popularity rating. Why do you still have to leap to his defense? Why don't you correct the wrong? Why do you still tolerate this situation? He's got 4 years or more in office. Do you think the administration will go on like this for the next 4 years? Don't you feel ashamed? As a civil servant, I mean, do you think the civil servants will find it very difficult to carry on? I feel that the administration is really going to extraordinary length in order to get what they set out to do. And they are prepared to go to any length to get things done. I heard what you said, Mr. Secretary. I'm wondering whether you are really true to your conscience. Mr. Deputy, I fully understand that given the composition of this council, it would be well nigh impossible for us to carry this motion, but we still have to do it. We've had three chief executives, and the problems are really getting worse. Given all these problems, why don't the government officials mull over them? Why do you blindly jump to the defense of the chief executive? What good does it do you? A moment ago, Mr. Albert Ho said that if someone supported the chief executive, they would enjoy certain, they would be given certain positions when the chief executive is elected. Now, we are talking about transparency here. Why is it that the chief executive is not bold enough to admit to that. He can say that he's going to form his cabinet, and he promised all these positions. I think this is not really the case. Well, the case is he's not being promised a position. How can this be a proper undertaking? Of course, we're hearing one side of the story, and we are seeking to conduct an investigation. What's wrong with that? I'm not sure how ICAC is going to proceed, is going to investigate this or to deal with this. But Mr. Tam, the secretary, you're urging fellow councillors to not support the motion. Now, with the benefit of hindsight, has the buildings department done anything enough? We're all aware of that. They just knock on the hollow wall, and they left it at that. Had it not been for the media, we would not have been able to uncover the basement. Did you find out about it? Is it fair? Is it just? Is it equitable? I think you're really blindly telling untruth. Since the new administration has come in, people are getting the perception that the officials up and down the hierarchy are lying. How can we go on like this, Mr. Secretary? So I hope that when you take the floor to speak in a few moments, that you will not jump to the defense of the chief executive. Rather, you should be acting like a just official and be true to your conscience and urge members to support Cyd HO's motion instead of covering the whole thing up. Thank you.
Dr. Helena Wong. Thank you, Mr. Deputy. Concerning this issue, as Mr. Albert Ho said, apparently we're discussing it a third time. Why is it that we still want to raise the issue? As colleagues said just now, members of the public need to know the truth. Today, the Democratic Party will support Ms. Cyd HO's motion to appoints a select committee and to invoke the Electoral Powers and Privileges Ordinance. The reasons are simple. With new evidence disclosed. Besides, the new evidence is very serious in its allegations. The person alleged or accused is the highest ranking official in the government, the chief executive. Are the evidence true or are they fabricated? Did the CE involve himself in corruption? Was he involved in triad members? And Mr. Lu Monhong is also involved. Who is telling the truth? Who's telling false information? The public needs to know. Is there any false statement or misrepresentation on the part of the CE? Did the three professionals exist, or are they only fabricated figures? We have to trace this. With the disclosure of new evidence, the CE, if he came out at the first instance, to explain himself and in a sincere and open manner, offered clarification and explanation, as he said, it would be good. But then there are no clarifications or explanations, so nobody knows the truth. If we do not clarify all these, in the next 5 years, within the term of Cy Leung, he won't have any comfortable days because members of the public have a big question mark about his credibility and integrity. If we don't ask, it doesn't mean that he's credible. He has integrity, no. Members of the public still slight and despise the CE. So why don't we do the CE justice? Why don't we do Mr. Lu Monhong justice? We need to know the facts and truths. Therefore, the Democratic Party will support the appointment of a select committee. More worrying is that not just that the CE did not frankly and honestly clarify the new evidence, he even issued lawyers letters to commentators and newspapers, including Dr. Joseph Lien. We never had the experience of past governors and past CEs resorting to this means when they're criticized. Well, for lawyers' letters, he's not an ordinary citizen. The CE is a chief executive. He's a powerful person. He has to issue lawyers' letters to these parties. Is it not that the CE has information officers to serve him? He has all the means to explain himself. He can come out and tell us that Joseph Lien falsely accused him. There are normal avenues to do all these, but he did not resort to them. Why should he issue lawyers' letters? He wants to threaten the media? Does he want to threaten commentators? Anyway, there's an impact here. Commentators dare not comment or criticize the CE. The media will know what they should do. That will become a trend. And the pro-establishment members will also know what to do. They won't dare to set up a select committee. Media dare not report. Commentators dare not comment. LegCo members dare not set up select committees. If we go down that path, all those who wish to pursue the truth will be placed under huge pressure. Officials, LegCo members, today we only have a very humble wish. That is to do the public justice. Let them understand what had happened. We're not saying who is telling the truth, who is cheating the public. We just want truth, the truth. We want all parties concerned to come out and clearly explain and respond to all allegations. The responsibility of the LegCo is to monitor the executive. And the CE is the highest ranking official in the administration. LegCo members are morally and constitutionally responsible for finding out the truth. We must find out whether or not the CE has the trust of Hong Kong people and should continue to govern Hong Kong. This is our responsibility. Why should we evade the truth? What persons will use all sorts of means to stop people from finding the truth, to stop the media from discussing the matter, and to stop the legislature from investigating into the matter? Very simple. The party concerned does not want to face the truth, because when the truth is uncovered, it will be to his disadvantage. So the other parties are trying to defend him. We know that some members of the public will say or ask why the Democrats wants to chase after Wai-chun Leung like that, and we should give him time to improve people's livelihood. Well, these are two different matters. The CE's policies can be discussed on another occasion. But when we face such a serious allegation, LegCo members are duty-bound to find out the truth. As a member of the Democratic Party, therefore, I'll support the motion. Thank you.
Does any member wish to speak? Secretary for Constitutional and Mainland Affairs. Mr. Deputy. Mr. Deputy, in relation to today's motion, I have, after consultation of the CEO's office, I have been authorized to respond to the motion. The purpose of Ms. Ito's motion is to set up a select committee to investigate into whether the CEO has provided a false statement of misrepresentation in relation to his UBWs. On the 13th of December last year, he issued a very detailed statement giving account of the UBWs and his residence. Oui.
On the 10th of February, the CE attended a Q&A session in this council, giving all the details, and he has also responded to media inquiries on many occasions. In fact, he has given very solemn replies on many occasions, and he has said that he was careless. He apologized to members of the public many times, and he said that he would serve the public with his whole heart. And last year in December, Mr. Wu Chi-wai moved a motion of no confidence in this council, and Mr. Lee Cheuk-yan on the 19th of December last year moved a motion on invoking upon the Powers and Privileges Ordinance. And then on the 9th of January this year, Mr. Leung Kwok Hong moved a motion of impeachment under Article 73(9) of the Basic Law. And on all three occasions, the motions were voted down after thorough debates. We are of the view that LegCo should no longer draw on this issue. In June last year, Mr. Albert Ho lodged an election petition and a judicial review on the outcome of the CE election. Mr. Leung Kwok Hong also took some legal action, and such cases have been concluded. And concerning Ms. Sid Ho's motion, she wants an inquiry or inquiry into whether Mr. Leung has given any improper undertaking in exchange for the support of members of the EC when he stood for the 2012 CE election. Now, our elections, including the CE election, are all conducted in a strict accordance with the Basic Law and relevant legislation. The EAC is responsible for a body. It's headed by a High Court judge, and the police and the ICAC are the law enforcement agencies. These arrangements make sure that our elections are held in an honest and transparent manner and in a fair manner. ECICO applies to the CE election. The purpose is to curb any corrupt and illegal practices in elections. If anyone has a complaint, then he should complain to the law enforcement agencies in accordance with the relevant legislation, and the law enforcement agencies will carry out an investigation impartially and fairly. With regard to allegations under the ECICO, as they may involve criminal offences, the fairest way to deal with such allegations is to make complaints to the relevant law enforcement agencies. Now, concerning the alleged giving of improper undertaking, complaints have already been lodged with the ICAC, and so it is not necessary and not appropriate to have an inquiry and an investigation carried out by LegCo. Now, we hope that all these can come to an end. We hope that the CE and SAL government can work with one heart for the benefit of society. We have a number of livelihood issues which require short-term, medium-term, and long-term policies and measures. And we need to have all sectors of society putting aside their disputes and working together to build a better community for our future generations. Now, LegCo members are all wise and understanding leaders, and I'm sure you'll make the right decision. So I would like to urge members to oppose Ms. Cyd Ho's motion.
I now call upon Ms. Cyd Ho to reply. The debate will come to a close after Ms. Cyd Ho has replied. Ms. Cyd Ho, thank you, Mr. Deputy. First of all, I would like to say something about what is meant by the corruption in an election. According to the Secretary, a complaint has been lodged with the ICAC, so we should just let the ICAC investigate the case. Well, this is the legal definition of interest. It can be a loan or be an office or employed positions or contract for such positions. Mr. Liu Mohong said in the interview that if the CE, Mr. CY Leung, after he had announced his candidacy, he asked Mr. Liu Mohong what kind of role he would like to play in the new government. Ms. Cyd Ho, yes? I think we do not have a quorum.
We have a quorum, Ms. Cyd HO. Thank you, Mr. Deputy. Let me continue with my elaboration on ECICO and what is meant by the corruption in election. I was saying that the interest would include advantages, jobs, employment, and so, and contracts for such. And also in section 11.1a, providing a benefit to another one to induce someone to vote or not to vote for a certain candidate. So if what Mr. Liu said is correct, and the conduct is corruption in election. When he asked what Mr. Liu would like to play, would like to assume in the new government, that happened after the forum to show support for Mr. Wai Leung. And why do I want to move this motion even after a complaint has been lodged with the ICAC? Because in section 11(5), there's a matter of concern. Any candidate or another person will not, because of entering into a contract to do something in the elections, constitutes an offense. So that's why in my motion I talk about an improper undertaking. There are so many competent and smart lawyers who can try to invoke this ordinance. Mr. Liu is no longer is a member of CPPCC, so the undertaking did not materialize. So the ICAC may not be able to get to the bottom of the matter. And the ICAC investigation is going to be a narrow one. It's on criminal matters only. But if we look at it from the perspective of political ethics, the improper undertaking would affect our core value in good governance. If someone wants to stand for see election, and if the government team is lined up in advance, and then Mr. Liu to try to lobby on his behalf, then that would be okay, because that's just a political operation. It's not something done behind the scene. And it's not because you are promised something because you have worked so hard for a certain election. Mr. Deputy, we have to find out exactly what happened, what transpired between the two, Mr. Liu and Mr. Wai Leung, and what kind of exchanges took place. Such a political maneuver is in breach of political ethics, and also undermines the good governance of Hong Kong. Mr. Wai Leung says he embraces meritocracy in making appointments. But in Mr. Liu Menghong's case, the offer of a executive council position is not because of merit, but because of political support, and that was an undertaking made for the purpose of a reward. There's no reason why Hong Kong people should foot the bill, so to speak. Many people would like to be a member of CCPCC. And the secretary knows this. There was one previous FS who formulated a tax increase policy to increase a vehicular registration tax. And yet he purchased a car before the plan was announced in order to save $200,000 in tax. But there are other policies covering other areas. So if an executive councillor does not conduct himself properly and try to reap business benefits through the insider information, that would be very serious. So if we have executive councillors who have no integrity, Hong Kong's interest is compromised. And moreover, this person who thought that there would be something given in return might resort to the unscrupulous measures in electioneering, and that's what Mr. Yiu-chung says in his article, that he tried to solicit support from people with triad background. Well, there was an alleged triad related person at that gathering. Was he there to ensure support, or was he there to pay for the meal? Well, actually, Mr. Wai Leung should have make it clear that this particular person was not one of his supporters. So we don't know what happened between this candidate and this supporter of the candidate. That's why we need an investigation. Because the incident could have drag in people with triad background. And Mrs. Fanny Lord went to lodge a complaint with the ICAC, and that's what some people regard as a politicization of the ICAC. There was a two-page report published in the press. There's a letter dated the 19th of January 2013, and it was alleged to be a letter sent by Mr. Liu Menghong to Mr. Wai Leung asking that pressure be brought on the ICAC in respect of a case involving Mr. Liu. From this letter, we would suspect that there's some exchange of benefits, political benefits, because of Mr. Liu's involvement as a electioneering supporter. So are we going to be like the mainland, that officials can cover up cases or crimes or investigations because of one's political standing? So this is an alleged exchange of political benefits. Was there any improper conduct behind the scene? Well, the answer may be so serious that the SAR's governance would be affected at its very core. That's why I want to propose the setting up of a select committee invoking our powers and privileges so that we can invite witnesses to testify. Another damage that is going to be caused is that Mr. Wai Leung's conduct has affected our press freedom. According to this iSun Affairs article, as I've told some press people, those allegations are very specific, and they point to criminal matters. Mr. Wai Leung should take concrete action to clarify the matters and also ask Mr. Liu Menghong to clarify. But Mr. Wai Leung has tried to avoid this. Even a long period of questioning failed to yield any answer. Mr. Lin Yuzhang's article resulted in a solicitor's letter sent by Mr. Wai Leung to Hong Kong Economic Journal and to Mr. Lien. That article was based on the story, the interview given by Mr. Liu Menghong, and this is the last paragraph, and I want to quote. On the other hand, Hong Kong would be injured if triad elements are involved in our government. Therefore, we need to find out the truth in a very serious matter. We should allow, we should ask the electrical to get all the information from the three persons involved. But this is not going to happen because the pro-establishment camp would try to clamp down on this. I think Mr. Lian was only talking about something based on past experience. And the following 100 characters would represent the fiercest attack on Mr. Siwa Leung. Well, those involved are CPPCC members. They might be even be Communist Party members under the leadership of the CCP. Well, these people may be asked to give an account in a specified place at a specified time in somewhere in on the mainland. Might be the more appropriate way of dealing with this. And the title is that, well, this is not a question of integrity. The involvement of Triad would mean that Mr. Siwa Leung may be subject to the CCP disciplinary action. Well, I have corresponded with Mr. Lian through email. And I know that this article has talked about the way CCP discipline its members. If Mr. Siwa Leung thinks that this article is a defamation, why doesn't he ask Mr. Liu to clarify his allegations, Mr. Liu's allegations? Instead, why did he choose to send a solicitor's letter to Mr. Lian and the Hong Kong Economic Journal? Actually, in his election campaign, Mr. Siwa Leung signed a charter on press freedom. That's the 17th of January in the Hong Kong JA event in 2012. He promised that after his election, he would safeguard freedom of the press, and he will try to enact a law on freedom of information. He has now breached both promises. He sent a solicitor's letter to the newspaper and to the writer solely because of an article. How can this be safeguarding press freedom? We have got some English precedent cases. Officials should not issue solicitors' letters lightly on the basis of alleged defamation, because officials and their action carry significant public interest, and officials should not invoke the laws that are supposedly there to protect the private interest. This is really questionable. Mr. Po Chair. Well, she has spoken 5 to 10 minutes, but the contents are not related to this motion. Thank you, Mr. Deputy. Maybe Mr. Porcher was not here a moment ago. He was not there when I started. I said at the very beginning, that's about some exchange of political interests and something else might have happened behind the scene. Mr. Siwa Leung promised to enact a law on freedom of information. As a party to the incident and as a public figure, he issued a solicitor's letter instead, and the truth is kept from the public. In Taiwan, People's Progressive Party tried to shoot Mr. Chen Shui-bian, and they lost significantly in the subsequent legislative yuan election. And then Mr. Ma Ying-jeou became the next president. But in Hong Kong, we have no way to punish political figures in an election. So people have no choice but to take to the street, and I think justice will be done ultimately. I now put a question to you, and that is that the motion moved by Ms. Cyd HO be passed. Would those in favor please raise their hands? Those against, please raise their hands. I claim a division. Ms. Cyd HO claims a division.
开始表决。
Voting begins. Members, please check your votes. If there are no questions, voting is closed. The results are displayed. The results are members from FCs, 30 present, 9 for, 21 against, 0 abstain. Members returned from GCs, 31 present, 17 for, 13 against, 0 abstain. The question is not supported by a majority respective of each of the two groups of members present. I declare the motion negative. The 6th and the 7th members' motions. These are two motions.